हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर राजीव गुप्ता फ्रॉम एसएमटी एमडी पटेल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फिजिकल साइंस एंड रिसर्च आनंद. द कोर्स नेम इज़ बीएससी केमिस्ट्री. द सेमेस्टर इज़ फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर. द सब्जेक्ट इज़ एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री विच आई एम टीचिंग इन बीएससी केमिस्ट्री course. The subject code is US05 CCHE24. The unit number is 3, which is chromatography second, and its first major topic is gas chromatography. In this lecture I am going to talk on injection ports, which has been used to inject our known or unknown sample into the GC instrument. So, sample unit or injection port. Sampling unit or injection port is attached to the column head, or it is just attached ahead to the column, means where the actual separation of components of a sample starts. At this starting point, just ahead to this starting point of column, this injection port is attached in the instrument. So in this injection port we inject our sample using these type of syringes. See, these micro syringes. What are micro syringes? These syringes have very low volume, means through these syringes we can insert our liquid sample inside the column in very low amount, means we can inject 0.1 microliter to 5 microliter of our sample. Since the sample should be in vaporized state, as we know that in gas chromatography, the mobile phase which contains sample, the sample should be in its vaporized state. So the injection port is provided with an O1, means this injection port is situated inside the instrument, which covered by an O1, which helps to maintain its temperature. Means this injection port in the instrument has higher temperature during experiment. This temperature should be about 20 to 50 degrees Celsius above the boiling point of the sample, because this somewhat higher temperature then boiling point of sample makes the sample get immediately in vaporized state when we insert this through the syringes. So as the sample, which could be a liquid, generally liquid sample, is injected into the injection port, then immediately it converts into vapor state, because its temperature of injection port is higher than boiling point of the sample, and this vaporized sample immediately mixed with carrier gas. We could also insert or inject gaseous sample also. Okay, here example of liquid sample is shown. We can also insert gaseous sample. This sample may be introduced by using a gas tight hypodermic needle, a type of specific needle which is gas tight, where this sample, our sample, is filled in gas state, already in gas state. Okay, and the volume of this needle, of this syringe, this type of syringe will be 0.5 to 10 ml, could be 0.5 ml to 10 ml capacity. Okay, For liquid sample, these type of micro syringes has been used, which contains the area or volume of 0.1 to 100 microliter capacity, depending on the our sample. Sample could be dissolved in a solvent or sample could be present in its neat state. So depending on that condition, the volume of the syringe, used micro syringe, could be changed, or different type of micro syringes or different volume containing micro syringes could be used to inject the sample into the injection port. Now, sample injection system, column efficiency requires that the sample be of suitable size and be introduced as a plug of vapor. To enhance the efficiency of column, the sample size should be suitable, means the sample should be completely resolved inside the column, should be completely resolvable inside the column. So we get different peaks for different type of components which are present in sample. So we should insert suitable size, means if sample is highly resolvable at its higher quantities, then we can use high quantities of this sample using higher volume containing micro syringes. And these samples are introduced as a plug of vapor, means as this introduced inside the injection port, then it should not go back or destroy by other things, means its flow is unidirectional, one directional. So this plug term is used for that. Slow injection of oversized samples caused band spreading or poor resolution. Slow injection of oversized sample. These oversized sample means samples which contains higher amount of sample. That samples which contains higher amount of actual samples. If we introduce these samples in slow manner, then these samples spread inside the column as a band and will not separate completely. So this will give poor resolution. Due to this poor resolution, these all components will not be completely separated inside the column in the experiment, then we will not get a clear resolved peaks in the detectors. So detectors cannot detect the samples completely. So we get somewhat less precise, less accurate results. The most common method of sample injection involves the use of micro syringe, as we already seen earlier, to inject a liquid or gaseous sample. For both type of samples, sample could be a liquid. Liquid means a sample could be in its neat form, pure neat form means liquid form, or it could be dissolved in a organic solvent or any other solvent. So this could be a liquid or this could be a gas. So both type of samples, these type of micro syringes has been used. These samples are introduced in the instrument by a self-sealing system. That self-sealing system is already a system which contains this injection port. A silicone rubber diaphragm, or septum into a flash vaporizer port located at the head of the column. The sample port is ordinarily about 50 degrees Celsius above the boiling point, as we have already seen earlier. See, what is this silicone rubber diaphragm? In this silicone rubber diaphragm, we can put the needle of this micro syringe directly into this diaphragm or septum, and inject this sample inside the sample injection chamber, okay, where these samples vaporize immediately in the presence of this higher temperature. So this silicon rubber diaphragm just provide a type of plug where these samples could not go backward direction from the column, from the instrument. So this is the simple type of injection port is shown, complete injection port, where this is the micro syringe which is inserted from this top side. This is the septum. See what is the septum? This was the silicon rubber diaphragm or septum. This type of septum is used where the syringe is inserted into this septum and go through this septum and comes into this vaporization chamber. So this septum covers this syringe, which is made up of silicon type material, covered like this, that this becomes airtight or block, means any material cannot go outside and outside air cannot go inside this vaporization chamber. Now this syringe needle throws this sample inside this vaporization chamber, which contains higher temperature, somewhat 20 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius from the boiling point of this inserted sample, and this liquid sample directly converts into vapor form. Then this vapor form immediately mixed with this carrier gas, which is coming from this side, from this carrier gas reservoir or cylinder. Through this regulator, this carrier gas is flowing from this side, and here both vaporized sample and carrier gas mixed, and these mixture of carrier gas and sample then after goes to column, directly to column. Okay, so in this complete instrument we see the sample remains in its vaporized form. Here a term is shown, that is zero dead volume. That zero dead volume means a volume inside this vaporization chamber. The volume of this vaporization chamber is considered as a zero dead volume in this experiment. The volume that is not considered as retention volume, okay, is not considered in retention volume of a sample. Actually, the retention volume V, which we consider only the volume of column where this vaporized sample covers the volume, that is considered column volume. Now various types of injection techniques for different types of sample. As we know that sample types could be different depending on their boiling point or their other nature, the injection port techniques which are introduced in this instrumentation could be different. Injections of sample into capillary columns, for capillary type columns or open tubular columns, which these type of columns which we will study in further lectures. For this type of columns, split like injection technique is used. See, split injection technique is used. What is the meaning of split? When we inject a sample inside the injection chamber, sample injection chamber, then this sample splits into two parts. One part goes into the column and other part removes as a residue, or we can say removes from this experiment, from the column. Okay, so if we have higher amount of samples, means our sample is oversized, means the quantity of sample is higher inside the syringe, means this type of injections or injectors are used when our sample is a pure sample, neat sample, which is not dissolved in a solvent. So that higher amount sample could create a type of less resolution inside the column. So we use this type of split technique. It splits the volume of sample stream into two unequal flows. Okay, as I said earlier, this it divides the sample into two streams of unequal flows by means of a needle valve and allow the smaller flow to pass onto the columns. These two divisions of two partition of these sample, a low amount containing partition goes into the column and the bigger part of this sample allowed to be vented to the atmosphere, means it removes the instrument or experiment and goes outside from the instrument to the atmosphere. This technique is not suitable when highest sensitivity is required. So what is the meaning? Means suppose we have a type of sample which is not, which could not be dissolved in an organic solvent or not that facility is available. So we, what we do, because suppose we have high volume syringe, high volume micro syringe that contains pure or neat sample which contains many components. So that neat sample, we cannot allow that sample to go into the column because there the resolution or other things will not happen correctly inside the column. Also, it creates some problem inside the column when the sample amount is very high. So some big portion of the vaporized sample we allow to move away from this instrument or vent it to the atmosphere. See this assembly, this is a capillary split injector and split leads injector. Both type of assembly shown is a single diagram. First we are considering split. See split, this split injections, we can see here this injection port, this is injection chamber, this is needle. Okay, this is a carrier gas flow regulator, and from this side the carrier gas is flowing inside the column. This is the split vent from where the second portion of the vaporized sample, which is not required during experiment, is vented out. Okay, is vented out from this side. So when the higher amount of sample is injected inside this sample injection chamber, then immediately it vaporized, then mixed with this carrier gas, and some portion goes into the column. See, generally for this type of injectors are used for capillary GC columns. This goes to the column and a broad portion of this sample goes to the atmosphere from this split vent. Okay, from this, through this split vent, it goes to the atmosphere. And this split vent could be programmable, means if we want to let higher amount of sample go outside the instrument, or if we want to vented out low amount of sample, then this is programmable, means adjustable. Okay, so this is the split injection. In split less injection, this split vent will not present. Okay, in that type, means we can say that by programming we completely close this valve. We completely close this valve, then no sample gas or vapor, sample vapor could go through this side or outside the atmosphere. So whole the sample will go into the GC column in split less injector. So see, our next point is split less injector. They allow all the sample to pass through the column. As I said, for loading, sample should be very dilute to avoid overloading of the column. See, where we use split less injector, where our sample amount or quantity is very low. Okay, because we know that GC instrument works well, very well on the lower amounts, very low amounts of the sample, and actually it requires very dilute or very low amount of sample. So if our sample is already in already contains a very low amount, means the sample is diluted in using a organic solvent, then the whole sample could go into the column. So we use this type of splitless injector to avoid overloading of the sample, and a high capacity column such as SCOT or heavily coated WCOT column should be used. For this type of columns, these injectors are used. This SCOT is solid support coated open tubular column, and it is wall coated open tubular column. These two types of columns we will see in further lectures which are related to a topic of column. So these both type of columns are open tubular column. So splitless injectors are also considered or used for these type of open tubular columns. So the key point is the sample amount is very low. So there is no splitting or separation in two parts is required for this type of sample. So we use splitlet injectors for this type of samples. Now the third is on column injectors. What are on column injectors? A syringe with a very fine quartz needle is used. In this case, in these type of injectors, the micro syringe are used which contains very fine quartz needle, air cooled to minus 20 degrees Celsius below the boiling point of the sample. After then, the warmer air is circulated to vaporize sample. See, these on column injectors are used for that type of samples which degrade at higher temperatures or their boiling points. Or above their boiling points, means we have some compounds, we may contain that organic compounds which degrade at higher temperatures, because as we know that generally the temperature in injection port is 20 to 50 degrees Celsius higher than the boiling point of sample. But if sample degrades at these higher temperatures, so we use these type of injectors where we lower the temperature somewhat, minus 20 degrees Celsius, lower the temperature from boiling point or below this boiling point, okay, of this sample. Then this type of sample is directly injected into the column. It is not injected in injection port, means actually injection port is not present in these type of injectors. These injectors inject the syringe directly at the head of column, means the assembly is made up of like this, that there is no time available to degrade that sample. As we just inject the sample into the column, these immediately separated and detected by the detector. So there is no time is available for this sample to degrade. Okay, so this type of samples which degrade at higher temperatures or temperatures of their boiling point or higher than boiling points, so these type of on column injectors are used. Again, this diagram is shown for split and splitlet injectors. This is the assembly. From this top side, this rubber septum, which is actually silicon material containing septum, from this top side we put that micro syringe needle on this, and it injects the sample inside this इंजेक्शन चैम्बर विच और वेपोराइजेशन चैम्बर विच वेपोराइज द सैम्पल. फ्रॉम हियर दिस कैरियर गैस इज कमिंग इनसाइड दिस वेपोराइजेशन चैम्बर. दिस इज द हीटेड मेटल ब्लॉक. सी दिस इज द जैकेट और वी कैन से अ टाइप ऑफ ओवन विच इज अ थर्मोस्टैट विच कंटेन्स अ टाइप ऑफ असेंबली विच आर हीटेड एंड मेक्स दिस कंप्लीट सिस्टम और टू मेक दिस सिस्टम एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर. ओके सो दिस इज द हीटेड मेटल ब्लॉक विच प्रोवाइड्स अ थर्मोस्टैट विच वर्क लाइज अ थर्मोस्टैट टू रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट द टेम्परेचर इन साइड दिस वेपोराइजेशन चैम्बर. दिस इज अ ग्लास लाइनर ग्लास लाइनिंग इन विच दिस सैम्पल वेपोराइज. इमिडिएटली दिस सैम्पल मिक्सड विद दिस कैरियर गैस एंड गो इन साइड द कॉलम. इफ वी यूज स्प्लिट इंजेक्टर दैन सम पोर्शन दैट सम हायर अमाउंट पोर्शन गोज थ्रू दिस स्प्लिट एंड गो थ्रू दिस आउटलेट टू द एटमोसफियर. If we use splitless injector, if we want splitless type injection, then we close this outlet. Okay. Now for these both type, this assembly will be same. Now the fourth one is automatic injectors. Generally in today's days, nowadays, these type of injectors are used where we have to analyze more than one sample, one by one. Where attendant or operator is not required with the whole analysis. Means if we want to analyze 10, 20 or 100 samples, okay, very high number of samples, then these type of instruments are automatic, completely automatic, and take the sample one by one after each experiment. For improving the reproducibility and if a large number of samples are to be analyzed, okay, or operation is required without an attendant, means if complete operation takes more time, means 2 hours, 3 hours, 5 hours for these higher number of samples, then the operator attendance near the instrument is not required. And these automatic type injectors are used. See, there could be various samples which are put in this tray, in this sample tray. The solid samples are introduced as a solution or in a sealed glass ampoule. See, if our unknown sample or known sample which contains more than one component is solid, then we have to necessarily dissolve this solid sample into a proper solvent to make a solution. Okay, or we can use these type of sealed glass ampoule. These glass samples crushed in the gas stream with the help of gas tight plunger and the sample gets vaporized. So these two type of method could be used. We can use these type of solutions, or this solid sample could directly be put into this glass ampoule, which this glass ampoule is directly put into the vaporization chamber. There it is crushed and the gas stream, heated gas stream, converts this solid sample directly into its vaporized state, and this vaporized sample flows into the column under the influence of a carrier gas. So this is the overall tabulated form of these basically three types of injectors. Split injectors, which contains, which enters only 0.1 to 1% sample into the column, and remaining 99% sample will be will be vented out to the atmosphere. So only 1% almost 1% sample will go into the column. In splitless injection, whole amount of sample which is present in the syringe goes into the column. So here the amount of sample will be very low. This type of injection is best for quantitative analysis. See, this split injection analysis, in which this split injection is used, this analysis generally is best for qualitative analysis. But this splitless injection technique, which is used for analysis, that could be a best analysis for qualitative. Okay, because we want to know the quantity of that substance present in our sample. On column injection, it is used because our sample may degrade or decompose above its boiling point. So we don't use these type of injectors. Okay, no heated injection ports are used in these type of samples. Here the samples are directly injected into the columns. Okay, directly injected at the head, where the actual experiment starts, inject, and we get these chromatography curves. Inlets are points of sample introduction. Ideal sample insert inlets for column type. Depending on the column, for various types of columns, different type of injection ports could be used. For packed columns and capillary columns, two types of columns. These capillary columns are also known as open tubular columns, and these are packed columns where no lumen inside the column is free. Whole the portion inside the glass tube or steel tube is filled with a solid or liquid stationary phase. So these are packed column, but here the liquid stationary phase generally coated over the wall, insider wall of this capillary, or these are called open tubular, means some portion inside the column is free from liquid stationary phase. So in this type of columns, generally flash vaporizer or on column vaporizer technique is used. Or for capillary type columns, split injector, splitless injector and on column type injectors are used. So generally we have seen earlier, these injectors generally used for these capillary columns. Or for these type of packed columns, flash vaporizer and on column vaporizer are used. Split injector, the advantages and disadvantages of these injectors are shown here. Split injector technique is the oldest technique which is used for open tubular columns. Simplest and easiest injection technique. What are the advantages of this split injection? We get high resolution of various components, means high resolution of separations, because in split injector, very low amount of sample goes inside the column. So this very low amount of sample gives very high resolution, means there is no mixing of these components inside the column. So these components are completely dissolved inside the column because these are present in low amount. In this case, neat sample can be introduced. Suppose we have a type of sample which cannot be dissolved in a proper solvent. So it in its neat state means pure sample state without solvent, we can introduce using this type of split injectors. Dirty samples can be introduced by putting a deactivated glass wool plug in the liner to trap non-volatile components. Suppose the sample, which is in its neat state, contains some type of impurities, some type of dirtiness, then these dirtiness can be removed just before the entering into the column using these deactivated glass wool plugs or a type of membranes or filtering components, where some non-volatile components could be inorganic salts or some other type of compounds. These non-volatile components will be separated in these deactivated glass wool plugs. Now the disadvantage: trace analysis is limited. Okay, trace analysis means if we want a very low amount of, if we have very low amount of sample, then this could not be analyzed using this split injector. Process sometimes discriminates between high molecular weight solutes so that the sample entering the column is not representative of sample injected. Suppose, as we have neat samples, these samples may contain high molecular weight solutes, so the sample component which we have to analyze could not be resolved or could not be shown during analysis, after analysis, means their peaks could not be get, or these could be discriminates in the presence of these high molecular weight solutes which are already present in the sample. So this is the some disadvantage of a split injector. Now, splitless injector, what are the advantages and disadvantages of this injector? In this case, the sample has to dilute it in a volatile solvent. It is very well known that we have very low amount of sample and this sample will be dissolved in a volatile solvent. Okay, here the sample could be solid or liquid, whatever, but its amount will be very low and it will be diluted, or we make a solution into a volatile solvent. Around 1 to 5 ml is injected in the heated injection port. Of this solution, we inject 1 to 5 ml into the injection port. Septum purge is essential in splitless injection because it contains volatile solvent, so this septum is necessary. Advantages of splitlet injection: improved sensitivity over a slit injector. Over a split injector, its sensitivity is higher, means this type of injector can determine the sample as quantitatively as well as qualitatively, means qualitatively as well as quantitatively, means we get both type of results in proper way, quantitative and qualitative. But in case of split injector, we don't get a proper quantitative analysis. Now, what are the disadvantages of splitlet injector? It is time consuming because first we have to dissolve this sample, very low amount sample, in a proper volatile solvent. Then these all things take much time. Also, after injection, this volatile solvent may create some problem in the analysis of the sample. Initial temperature and time of opening the split valve needs to be optimized. Initial temperature and time of opening the split valve needs to be optimized. It also requires some timing. In split valve, time opening means this volatile solvent which also vaporizes inside the sample injection chamber, this removes from the instrument using this split valve. Okay, somewhat we have to remove this volatile solvent from this instrument, not well suited for volatile compounds, boiling points of peaks of interest to be about 30 degree centigrade higher than the solvent. So overall what we can say that suppose this actually this split lattice injector is best for that type of samples which have somewhat higher boiling points than this volatile solvent. Choose volatile solvent, because when as we inject this sample inside the sample injection chamber with this volatile solvent, then this volatile solvent actually which has low boiling point vaporize faster and removes from this split valve, and only the actual sample goes into the column. But if our sample contains almost similar volatile nature as this volatile solvent, or contains low or high volatility compared to this used solvent, then we cannot use this technique, because this sample will go outside with this volatile solvent through these split valves. So this is not suited, this type of sample which is more volatile compared to this used solvent is not used in this type of split lattice injector. Okay, so it is not well suited for volatile compounds, boiling points of peaks of interest to be about 30 degree centigrade higher than the solvent, means which contains their boiling points lower than this solvent. Other types of inlets are shown here. These are direct injection or direct injectors. It involves in injection a small sample into a glass liner where vapors are carried directly into the column. This is the direct injection. It involves injection a small sample into a glass liner where vapors are carried directly into the column. It is just a type of split lattice injection where the sample does not contain any solvent. So it is injected over this glass liner. Here we can show this is the glass liner. See, this blue colored two objects are shown here. These are glass liner. So as the sample comes into contact with this glass liner, it converts into its vapor phase and directly goes into the column. So these are direct injection. On column injection, as we have already seen, where the sample contains degradable nature on its boiling point or higher than boiling point, so these are precisely injected by a aligned needle into the capillary column and making injection directly inside the column without using any injection chamber. Flash vaporizer, it involves in heating the port to a temperature well above the boiling point to ensure rapid volatilization. That is called flash vaporizer. Flash vaporizer means here the temperature is set inside the vaporizer chamber like this, that injected sample just converts into its vapor phase very rapidly and it goes inside the column. That is called flash vaporizer. These are all types of injection ports. Now static head space, it concentrates the vapor over a solid or liquid sample. Best chosen for residual solvent analysis. So these are all the various type of sample injection ports which are generally used in gas chromatography separation or gas chromatography identification instrument. So this is all about the injection ports of gas chromatography. Thank you for listening the lecture. Here a practical example is shown for this injection port. Here an injection port is shown, and this is the needle, our needle from where we inject the sample inside this port. And this injection port is actually situated inside this instrument, which is actually thermostated, which remains at a constant temperature during experiment.